Artificial intelligence has become a key behind-the-scenes component of many aspects of our day-to-day lives. From the virtual personal assistants such as Siri, Alexa, and Google Assistant, to the suggestions from your favorite music and TV subscription services. The promise of AI has lured many into attempting to harness it for social benefit, but there are also concerns about its potential misuse. It is already an important consideration when programmers create AI systems with specific functions, such as self-driving cars. Today, the so-called narrow AI that are designed to do one specific task are not capable of acting independently. They are designed with the sole purpose of enabling humans to complete their task more efficiently. Dr. Stuart Russell is one of AI's true pioneers and has been at the forefront of the field for decades. According to Russell, while these applications and expected developments in AI are enormously exciting, others, such as the development of autonomous weapons and the replacement of humans in economic roles, may be deeply troubling.
There are still a lot of people who, if you mention killer robots or autonomous weapons, their only exposure is the Terminator robot. And when we look at Terminator robots, they are large, slow-moving, heavy, vulnerable, and incredibly inaccurate. They shoot hundreds of bullets without hitting anybody. The robots we're talking about, when they shoot a bullet, it will hit its target. So we're thinking about systems that weigh less than an ounce, that can fly faster than a person can run, and can be launched in the millions. So being attacked by an army of Terminators is a piece of cake compared to being attacked by this kind of weapon.
The danger with the future of AI is the general AI that can perform many different tasks very well. A computer mind that improves, learns, and thinks like a human, or even exceed the level of human intelligence. A hypothetical scenario where AI becomes the dominant form of intelligence on Earth, with computer or robots effectively taking the control of the planet away from the human species, has become a significant point of controversy in the public imagination.
The worry arises from the possibility that machines may become smarter across the board, that they will develop general purpose capabilities. The possible risks from building systems that are more intelligent than us are not immediate, but the need to start thinking about how to keep those systems under control and to make sure that the behaviors they produce, the decisions they make, are beneficial to us. We need to start doing that research now. But in the history of nuclear physics, there was a very famous occasion when the leading nuclear physicist, Ernest Rutherford, said that extracting energy from atoms was impossible and would always remain impossible. The next day, Leo Szilard invented the nuclear chain reaction, and within a few months designed the first nuclear bomb. So sometimes it can go from never and impossible to happening in less than 24 hours. And just to give you an analogy, if someone said, well, you know, a giant asteroid is going to crash into the Earth in 75 years' time, would we say, oh, you know, let's, you know, tell me, come back in 70 years and we'll start thinking about it? No, we don't know how to destroy the asteroid, and so we would start working on it now to make sure that when the asteroid arrives, we have the technology we need to keep the human race going. So I think the analogy can be made to the possibility of superhuman AI.
Unlike humans, many systems with AIs are unable to understand the consequences of their actions. So the relevant question is, what level of control should be given to them, or whether they at all should be permitted to act autonomously in certain situations? In view of the recent warnings from researchers and entrepreneurs that artificial intelligence may become too smart, major players in the technology field are thinking about preserving human control. One such method is the development of an AI kill switch. This would be a technology that prevents AI systems from taking control of their own destiny. The concept of an AI kill switch has already been put forward by many prominent experts in the field of artificial intelligence. It was first raised by AI experts in 2013 when DeepMind technology demonstrated the ability of their computer program AlphaGo to beat one of the world's best Go players. Deep learning algorithms draw powerful insights from quantities of data typically beyond human comprehension, But what if machines become so superior in intelligence that humans lose control?
One of the things I think is a possibility in the not too distant future. We've already seen a lot of progress on brain-machine interfaces that allow, for example, someone who's completely paralyzed to control a robot arm to pick up a cup of coffee and have a drink. And that's done by direct connection of electrodes into neural tissue. And the amazing thing about that is that we don't understand the signals that the brain uses to control its effectors, right? Its arms and legs and so on. Basically, we leave it up to the brain to figure out what signals need to be sent to this robot arm to have it do what it does. It's not a conscious process, but with a relatively small amount of training, a monkey or a human brain, I don't want to say the monkey or the human because the human doesn't know what's going on. It's sometimes the brain is the one that figures out what signals need to be sent to this electrical system to get the robot arm to do what it wants. Just from common sense, you know, if you're a gorilla, are you happy that the human race came along and they're more intelligent than us? How are the gorillas doing right now? Probably not too well. So there's a common sense idea that having things smarter than you could potentially be a risk. The particular risk of having systems smarter than you comes from the fact that when you give a very, very intelligent system an objective, and let's hope we give them objectives, let's not leave it up to them to decide what they want to do. Let's make sure that they follow the objectives that we give them. The difficulty is, and we don't know how to specify objectives very well. And when you give an objective to a machine that's much more intelligent than you are, it's going to carry it out. It's not going to want to be turned off, because if you turn it off, it can't achieve the objective you gave it. So you're essentially setting up a chess match between the human race and machines that are more intelligent than us. And we know what happens when we play chess against machines.
Researchers acknowledge that robots may not always behave optimally, but they are hopeful that humans should ultimately be in charge. Some researchers are calling for an international effort to study the feasibility of an AI kill switch. According to them, future intelligence machines should be coated with a kill switch to prevent them from going rogue. An AI kill switch is a mechanism for restricting machine intelligence, by which humans, who remain in control, can intervene to override the decision-making process. Existing weak AI systems can be monitored and easily shut down and modified if they misbehave. However, a misprogrammed superintelligence, which by definition is smarter than humans in solving practical problems it encounters in the course of pursuing its goals, would realize that allowing itself to be shut down and modified might interfere with its ability to accomplish its current goals. If the superintelligence therefore decides to resist shutdown and modification, it would be smart enough to outwit its human operators and other efforts to shut it down. Russell postulates that it might be wise to build oracles as precursors to a superintelligent AI. An oracle is a hypothetical AI designed to answer questions but is prevented from gaining any goals or sub-goals that involve modifying the world beyond its limited environment. The oracle could tell humans how to successfully build a superintelligent AI and perhaps provide answers to difficult moral and philosophical problems. The oracle may also be used to determine how human values translate into an engineering specification for superintelligence. This would make it possible to know in advance whether a proposed superintelligence design would be safe or unsafe to build. Russell has proposed a novel solution, a new human-computer relationship, to solve the problem of superintelligence.
So the way I think about it is that everything good we have in our lives, everything that civilization consists of, is the result of our intelligence. It's not the result of our long teeth or our big scary claws. It's from our intelligence. So if AI, as seems to be happening, can amplify our intelligence, can provide tools that make us, in effect, much more intelligent than we have been, then we could be talking about, you know, a golden age for humanity, with possibly the elimination of disease, poverty, solving the climate change problem, all being facilitated by the use of this technology. So I am extremely optimistic that the upside is very great, and that's the reason why we need to make sure that the downside doesn't occur.
Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.